Greetings, Earthlings. Welcome to the Elder Scrolls Chapter 1 Arena. The best techniques are passed on by the survivors. Gaiden Shinji, Blade Master, First Era. Is that a 947? Maybe. Anyway, for centuries, different factions battled in petty wars and border conflicts until in Second Era to 896, the Type 7 crushed all those who opposed him to control, proclaiming himself as the Emperor. Still, the bitter years of the war left its effect on the populace. The name Tamriel, Elvish for Dawn's beauty, seldom fell from anguished lips. Damn, this goes by fast. Yeah, anyway, different sides of the same coin tossed every day. The people of the known world began calling the land of the sorrow the arena. Now, 492 years later, after Tiber stepped into control and kept the peace, the land of arena has a new threat, the Emperor, Uriel Septim VII. It just goes by. It is said that hope flies on death's wings, prepared then for as the Elder Scrolls foretold. What did they foretell? Anyway, so thank you for coming to my stream. More Uriel Septim VII, Emperor of Tamriel, stands with Yelan. They have been summoned by Yegathan, Imperial Battle Mage of Empire, on rumor of treachery. The Emperor is betrayed. Ooh, big twist. And transported to a dimension of Thann's choosing. Well, for those of you who don't know, it's one of the things of Oblivion. After months of preparation, Yegathan takes the throne. Actually, Oblivion. Rhea Silmane, once Thann's apprentice, is captured before she can warn the Elder Council of the Imperial Battle Mage's treachery. Manipulating the essence of magic, Thann prepares to take the true Emperor's place as ruler of the known land. That's a coup d'etat if I've ever seen one. The Imperial visit wastes no time in gathering his servants and turning them into trusted counterparts of the Emperor's guard. Okay, let's generate. So, welcome to this Let's Play or whatever you might want to call it. I basically thought that, you know, if I play video games, why not just actually capture it and put it up on YouTube? So here we go. Now, well, if you don't like the introduction video, the 15-second long introduction video with the annoying music, well, don't forget to unsubscribe and hit dislike on this video. Then again, you sort of need to be subscribed to it in the first place. So anyway, questions. What do I do here? You can pause it if you want to read it, if my voice is getting in the way. You know what, let's try and go for a warrior sort of character in this. So, I actually like the fact that they made this scroll of sorts which we can select from. How do I select this? Oh, I actually have to press the B button. I guess that looks like a warrior up in the corner, so I think I'm going down the right path here. This question is actually pretty tough, man. I mean, pretty moral questions. Yay! Enter again. That's basically how the real Berenzia begins. Well, I guess I should rather put my honor on the line here. That should be the most more warrior thing to do. So, yeah, I'm gonna choose A. Wait, that's a wizard? Damn. Okay, springs leaks and start to sink under the vortex. connects with your face, choosing to die with a sense of decorum and nobility, not as a common obvious the unknown. That sounds more like a wizardly choice. Dive into the churning current, you may be hastening your own death, but at least you're doing something. This is one situation which I don't know what I would be doing unless and until I actually come face to face with the situation. But it's a close comparison, like, it's a close tie between A and C. One sounds like escaping, but then again, you are putting yourself in more danger. And the other one is, well, basically fighting, I guess? I don't know which one would be the warrior's path. Choices, choices, choices are all that matter. Do they really though? Begin failing furiously. I think I'm gonna go with A on this one. What? A get wizardly choice? What? I could have sworn that was a warrior's choice. And falls towards her. Push my mom out of the way, grab the hot pipe and try and push it away, and position yourself between the pipe and my mother. I think sacrificial would be the warrior's way. So, C, I suppose. That's a thief's choice, what? Anyway, I don't understand the character creation logic behind these games, but alright. So that of many villages, if it works, you should keep the tradition. Not C, definitely. That worked. I also like how the choices which you make the most make the constellations much brighter. So, for those of you who don't know, these are basically the constellations in the... basically in Mundus. And... they basically represent your birth sign. They determine your strengths and your weaknesses to a great degree, to a great extent. The red guards were the first people who actually, well, basically cracked the code behind these constellations and how they influence you. Some TS astrology, if you will. Some of the reasons why I actually wanted to play Arena is because I've recently been thinking about the games which I played and which I liked, and I thought, why not start from the first installment, the very first installment of the series, and basically just observe how the games evolved over time in a narcissistic fashion. Yeah, that's a warrior's choice. Good. So yeah, so I decided to check out whether how these games evolved throughout the generations to reach where they are right now, and basically try and capture the true essence. And this game seems interesting up until now, especially the character generation part, how they basically create your character, the character class and stuff like that. So. Yeah, that's basically what got me here at this point. Trying to play games which were relevant way before I was born. Well, not way before I was born, but yeah, you get the point. Nobody plays them yet. Anymore. Nobody plays them anymore. So. I like this question. I like this question. What would I do in such an instance? Yeah, I'm gonna beat him up. I feel that is what the warrior would do. Yep. A barbarian. Hell no. I'm not gonna be a barbarian. No. Let's try the other one. Let's try selecting a character. There are a lot of character choices in this. I did not anticipate that. Like, damn. Warrior. Is there any warrior? I actually feel like that's a... Oh yeah, right there. So, I actually feel like the warrior is the most safest choice when going into a new game. So, Grimfangs, obviously. Male, please. From where dost thou hail, Grimfangs the warrior? Well, I'm gonna be a Nord because Skyrim. Interesting. So it's called Skyrim, the land of the Nords, his home. Yep. Strongest northern winds which sweep through the icy glaciers. The Arctic climate has the most violent foot. Life's cruel and bitter hand. That's something. Well, I mean, that is true in a sense. Bit of guidance. Please let thy fate be written in the Elder Scrolls. Wait, wasn't it already written in the Elder Scrolls? With that point, it's needed keeping in mind the recommendations for thy chosen class. Okay. Oh. Well, wait. That's. Dude, that's basically D&D, man. This is old school D&D. Talk about trip down memory lane. Anyway, so basically we've got strength, we've got intelligence, and what is that? Is that vitality? Agility, speed, endurance, persuasion, I think? Luck? Yeah, I'm just gonna go with higher strength and higher luck. Don't need intelligence as much as a warrior. Minus two. Is that supposed to be good, or is that supposed to be minus one? What? I think I'm not doing that right. Is that vitality, or is that something else? Oh no. I get the two hit and two defend part, but... Endurance and strength, I'm just gonna go with those two. Gonna reduce the vitality there by a point, and let's see, the system is complex. I'm not sure how the points really influence all of this. Should I increase the agility? Nah, I'm just gonna spend it all on vitality. Oh, is that vitality? That looks like it's spelled like with. Whatever that is. So this game is. I think I'm on the strength. I'm gonna go for strength here. Yeah, strength. Strength works. More damage. I am a warrior after all. I'm actually quite confused about how to proceed with this part here. Magic defense seems to be suffering, so... But I don't know whether that actually follows the same logic as the others, so... Huh. I guess I'll have to do a little bit of research, I think. Agility, it won't really matter, I guess? I guess I'm done. Let's go. Yeah, I'll just save the stats. Distribute all of your bonus points. Oh, I've still got one left. Where do I put it? Where do I put it? Strength? Okay. I will now choose the appearance. The mane can't be altered by clicking the face. Okay. Let's see what you got. Click, damn it. There we go. That's mean. Okay, that looks like a ruffian. I like that. Actually, not good. Let's just check whether there's anything else. Can't change those, just the face? Okay, let's check more as well.